You saw an airplane.
Hello there, morons. It's Victor, give me a break, man, king of the morons, godfather J-vlogging, and rumored alcoholic. Ooh, and here I am in the country doing a laundry vlog for you. Got one of my laundry t-shirts on. Love this company. That dog always used to bark at Maggie when Maggie was alive. We've always felt sorry for that dog, but who's laughing now? I guess he is, because Maggie's dead. Of course, Maggie had a much better life, not tied up with a 1 meter string, which I think is animal cruelty. This is a laundry vlog. If you don't know what a laundry vlog is, it's just a video that you don't really have to watch, just listen to. However, today we have a treat for you. As I've been doing recently, if you've been following the channel, because I've been making these videos, these laundry vlogs, but with visuals, meaning, yeah, you don't have to watch. However, I will try my best to make it visually interesting for you. And today, double treat, we've got a beer. I haven't had a beer on camera forever, or any alcoholic drink, except for the 2.5 Oyaji nights where I always have a little bit of whiskey. Some of you have been complaining, Victor, it's so strange you're not drinking on camera, which is what I like to do, you know, just for fun, just for effect. My in-laws don't drink, but they always have beer in the fridge, and I'm actually out in the country. Oh, I'm drunk already, man! Yeah. It's funny, some of you guys are like, oh, you're drinking, you must be drunk. You have one drink, you're drunk. Some of you guys are fucking lightweight, I gotta tell you. And I forgot, I almost edited myself. Not gonna be editing myself. But this is a good one, this is a good one. This is a really interesting video. And isn't it beautiful out here? I love coming out here and looking at the green fields, the tombo. This is tambo. This is called a tambo. Not to be confused with a tombo. Tambo is a rice field. And if you, you're not gonna be able to see, well, you might be able to see because this is a 4K camera. Yeah, I'm using the 4K, that's the other thing. This is the 4K camera on the iPhone 6S Plus. So the visuals will be improved, though only 36 FPS. But theoretically, the image should be better. Tell me what you think. Tell me what you think about this. So the bonuses today are the improved camera quality out in a beautiful setting, right? The tumble. And I just had a tombo land on my nose, which I won't be able to show you, but if you check out my Instagram, you guys should follow me on Instagram. I like posting funny. I think Instagram is misused. I think Instagram has a lot of funny potential, but I guess Vine took that over. Vine is a place for funny, but Instagram could be funny, you know. And today's topic, so the, what are the improved things? We got 4K, we got improved setting, new out setting. Oh yeah, I'm drinking, yeah. So three things today. And yeah, today's topic is a stupid letter I got from one of you guys. Some guy with a weird name. I think it might be Arabic or something. And it's a really weird, it's not even worth like reading completely because it's, I mean, to you. Not, I mean, okay, the English is obviously a second language for this guy. It was written in broken English, which is fine. I don't hold that against him. But it was, the subject header was real questions. And the first question was 1.4 million Japanese live in America. It's the second biggest Japanese community in the world. Why is that? Please ask a Japanese person about that. It said, why do Japanese people play baseball and what was the other sport? I think you said basketball in almost all high schools. And the other question was, don't they know that, why do they learn English? Because don't they know that the way when you learn a language, it changes the way you think. And there was some in one of those questions that threw in the fact that even though Japan lost the war to America, they still do things in an American way. And the other one was, why does Japan do business the American way? I mean, I don't know what that meant exactly. Economically, you know. And that was the, I think those are all, those were all the questions, maybe. The ending though, the thing that got me, the annoying part of was, and I want you to stay in the middle. I see you as a Latino. And if you don't have Latino pride, if you don't see yourself as a Latino, then you don't have any pride. So this is my answer to that. And I hate doing that, the middle finger, because it's childish, but I'm giving you the middle finger, buddy, because that's stupid. And it's something I've never really understood. Do I have Latino pride? No, I don't have any Latino pride. I don't have any ethnic pride or any racial pride or any pride from any group that I did not work hard to get into. Okay, so I think it's ridiculous to be proud of something that you had nothing to do with becoming. It's like, I'm proud to be a man. Really? Why? Why are you proud to be a man? What did you do? Did you when you were in an embryo, did you decide to grow a penis? Did you keep your estrogen levels up? I mean, you had nothing to do with being born a man. You're just born a man, okay? You were socially raised a man. I mean, you didn't even have much to do with it. Even when you were born, you could have been raised a woman. It's just ridiculous. Are you proud to be a woman? I bet you a lot of you are proud to be a woman, especially feminists. No. But there are people who are like, proud to be a woman, proud to be a man. All these expressions are just ridiculous. I remember there's a big scandal when Michelle Obama said, I'm finally proud of America. You know? Proud to be American, something was just ridiculous. Finally, like, why? How can you be proud of a country you're born into? If you think about it, the whole thing pride is just so stupid. I mean, I don't even know where to get started with it. Okay, let's go to the function of government first. And then we're going to actually answer this punk's stupid questions. So, first of all, the government's function is to take care of the people and to keep them protected, right? Keep them happy and safe. Do you all agree with me? Let me just make sure this baby's recording. So I'm just talking for 15 minutes for no reason here. Yes, 6 minutes, okay. Do you all agree with me? The function of the government is to keep the people safe and provide a atmosphere where they can get to your basic human needs like education and a protection from, you know, fraud and theft and shit like that. Basic medical care, you know. Protection from enemies and disease. Things like that, right? Like the Olympics, that's not really the government's job. And you know, my country is better than you is not the government's job. So I don't understand some of that mentality that goes into nationalism at all. My country is better than you doesn't really make any sense to me. Let me see. I had a really thought out thing about this. Hold on a second. Let me just gather my thoughts here. I'm just enjoying the scenery, so I'm a little bit distracted by it. Also, I was just told that there were actually snakes around here, but I've never seen one, though. I've walked around here quite a few times. I've seen tanuki here, wild tanuki, and storks and such, but never snakes. Okay, so that's the government's job, right? And that's all it should do. So all of this, let's make America great again. None of that really makes any sense to me. Let's just make sure that we can all, let's create an environment, frogs jumping, an environment where we can all make money and succeed. And that's basically what your government should be doing. So the pride factor, I think, is kind of muddies the water a little bit. Yeah, so there's something about this guy's email that seems to imply to me, it's a very short, badly written email, that Japan's pride, there's a tombo over there, I don't know if you guys can see that dragonfly on that corner there. There's a, shit. Okay, sorry. I'm gonna get there. Okay, so, okay, let's get to it. So Japan basically has no pride because they're doing things the American way. Well, goddammit, why is that true? They lost the war and still they're doing things the American way. They suck, you know. I really don't like it. So I wrote the guy back. I said, how old are you? And what's your nationality? And he wrote back a stupid answer, which was, I'm old enough to ask questions. Yeah, so it was a 3-year-old. You know, mommy, what's that? That's retarded. And I said, why are you interested in Japan? He goes, I'm not interested in Japan. So why the fuck are you bothering me in the first place? But I'm going to just use you to make fun of because you're stupid. Because pride of being Latino is stupid, and it's all connected to your question, which seems to indicate that you think Japanese don't have any pride because they do things in an American way. First of all, Japanese play a lot of sports that are not American. and that are distinctly Japanese. There are a lot of Japanese sports that I've never heard of, these weird games that kids play. Like there's one that's really retarded, to be honest. It's this long pole with a basket on top, and all the kids gather at the bottom and they have to throw the balls at the top into the bowl, right? That's a stoop into the net or whatever. So let me explain again. You have a long pole like that. Well, it's about 2.5 meters, 3 meters up. And all the kids on one team get all their balls and they throw them into the basket at the very top. And then another team is doing the same thing with another basket. And whoever gets the most basket in a limited minute or so wins. And that's like high school kids play that. Like high school, like third year, like 18-year-old kids, 17-year-old kids. I mean, it's not a competitive sport, of course, just a school sport, but it's still pretty stupid. And it's something I've never seen in another country before. They also play soccer. Soccer is really big here, too. So he criticizes Japan for playing basketball and baseball. But then why don't you criticize, like, every country in the world? Because maybe not baseball, but basketball, pretty much everybody plays baseball. And if Japan was so Americanized, and they play football, too, right? Which they don't. They don't play much hockey. They don't play American football. They do play baseball. They really like baseball. Why is baseball popular in Japan? I don't know. It just appeals to the Japanese. Maybe because it has rules and stuff, and Japanese like rules. I don't know. I mean, not really that interested. And the baseball they play here is Japanese baseball. It's quite different. But you think Japanese have no pride because they play American baseball? It's just ridiculous. Who cares? They do play basketball. They have really good basketball teams. I think the women's team is one of the top in the world. The women's basketball team. One of my students is actually going to be in the Olympics in Brazil, and I'm very proud of her. Pride, getting to pride. I'm very proud for her. Let's say I'm happy for her. I had nothing to do with her getting to the Olympics, but my natural instinct is to say I'm proud of her, like as if I had something to do with it. I had nothing to do with it at all. So that answers that question about sports. Why do they play American sports even though they lost the war? I don't think that has much to do with anything. Here's something that a lot of people don't get. The Japanese really don't hold much antagonism, or they don't hold grudges against the Americans for the war. Yes, they lost the war to the Americans, but they don't hold grudges almost at all. I rarely see any open aggression or negative conversations about Americans. There's a lot of negative conversation about other countries like Koreans or China and stuff, but it's mostly for what's happening. With China, what's happening now, because there's a lot of weird shit that happens, like they'll have riots in China and trash Japanese companies. A lot of it, of course, I think is a fear that China is going to take over in the area, and they are, I mean, they're huge, right? There are a billion people, and they're in the area, and they're growing, and they have the huge military, so of course people are a little bit scared of them. And South Korea, Japan doesn't really hate South Korea that much. Mostly they kind of just, I mean, they do badmouth them quite a bit when there's a crime. They'll say, oh, he must have been South Korean, but it's not as bad as people think on the Japanese side. From what I hear, the South Koreans really do hate, Koreans generally do hate Japanese. In Japan, there are a lot of Koreans. There are a lot of Korean restaurants, a lot of Korean food. Korean K-pop here is very popular. Amongst my high school students, quite a few of them like K-pop. Quite a few of them even study Korean. They really like it. So there's that as well. But anyway, back to the Americans. It's not like they really hate Americans at all. Why though? I mean, after the war, shouldn't they hate Americans? That is kind of a mysterious thing, and it's mostly a reflection of how we would react if we had our asses kicked. I guess, I suppose, if America had had its asses kicked by Germany, maybe they would hate Germans. America supposedly lost the war in Vietnam, right? But do we hate Vietnamese? No, actually, we don't even think about them. It's kind of they're a tiny little country that we had a military experience at that nobody really cares about. So, with Japan, why they don't hate America. Maybe it's because America helped rebuild them. America was pretty decent to them after the war. Of course, a lot of it was selfish. America has reasons to treat Japan nicely. They needed the location, right? The property, the real estate in this area. So there's that too. So not saying that America is great because they treated Japan nicely. I'm just saying, they did. But in the end result, for whatever reason, whether it was selfish or not, Japan got a pretty good deal after the war, and they were able to grow their country. And they were the top economic power for a little while, right? During the bubble and all that. I mean, they were huge. Everything was great in Japan. Things are not so good now, but still pretty good. Still pretty good. About the sports, I really have no comment. So they like the sports for some reason. Basketball, I can completely understand because you don't need a lot of space to play basketball, right? So it's very convenient. And the other thing is, it's just a fun sport. I mean, it's spread all over the world. They play basketball all over the world, so it's ridiculous to criticize Japan for that. About the English thing, why do Japanese learn English? Because learning another English screws up the way you think, and that's going to change the way they think. Well, Japanese are very, very good at not learning English. And, look at all these dragonflies. Mating and stuff. They suck at English, unfortunately. I'm very sad to say. Japanese are not very good at learning English, so that's kind of an irrelevant thing. Now, back to this guy's last sentence, which is, if I don't take pride in being a Latino, if I don't identify myself as a Latino, I have no pride. I have pride in the things that I have accomplished. I have no reason to be proud of being born by chance a Latino. And the other thing is, I'm not like a pure Latino. If I go to Peru, people don't look at me and say, oh, you must be Peruvian. I look different. I'm quite mixed. I don't think my heritage or my blood or my ethnicity is that. I don't identify that way. Okay. So if you want to look at it, I look back in my family history once. Occasionally I do out of curiosity or whatever. And one of my ancestors is Paredes, which is a Arabic name. And I think that name is even in the Quran or something. So there's a there's a high possibility that one of my ancestors is Arabic. And since one of my ancestors, my name is actually Italian. And my grandfather lived in Spain. So there's a good chance that maybe the Moors, are part of my ethnicity as well. So it's very possible that I'm part Arabic, Spanish, Italian. My grandmother's father was at least part German, if not pure German, and living in Peru. And she was, the other half of her was Indian Peruvian. So we got some Incan in there, some German in there. So let's go back again. We got Arabic, we got Italian, we got Spanish, we got German, we got Indian, right? And I was born in Peru. Now, am I supposed to be proud of the 1 year and 4 months that I spent in Peru before my parents dragged my ass to America? No, I don't think so. And though my father, I think, is fairly Peruvian in thought, and I think he's kind of proud to be Peruvian. I think he takes, I won't say proud, I'll tell you this, he takes joy in Peruvian things. Like, he enjoys Peruvian food, he enjoys Peruvian dances, and he knows all the dances and songs and stuff like that. And when I was a kid, they taught me all the local songs and stuff that, when I would go back to Peru every summer. Sorry about the wind, by the way. I know I'm supposed to get a wind mic, but I'm supposed to get something to protect this, but I wasn't planning on doing this video suddenly today. I was going to be home, but when anyway, long story short, I wasn't planning on shooting this video. I will sort out the wind problems in the future, okay? So just please put up with this for now. I hope it's not too bad. Back to the conversation. I take joy in things that are ethnic, but I can't say I'm proud of being that ethnicity. And I don't understand why anyone would be proud of being something that they were just born into. I don't get it. Now, I know a lot of you are. I posted on my Facebook the other day. Today, I said, are you proud of your whatever and why? There was one guy from Sri Lanka that says, I'm proud to be Sri Lankan. And I'm thinking, or Indonesia, I don't remember, to be honest, it didn't even matter to me because it seems to me, I mean, I hate to be bigoted, but it seems to me that people who, that kind of pride is a small-minded pride. If you're proud to be American or Sri Lankan, that's just silly. I mean, why? What did you do? Have you done something to forward the Sri Lankan cause or the American cause? What have you done to make America better? Do you have anything to do with it? I don't think so. Here's a huge grasshopper. Hello, huge grasshopper. Whoa, now he's gone. Oh, now he's flying away. And now he's in this branch. Whoa, now he's gone again. Okay, well, we're not going to be chasing him like Homer Simpson chasing a squirrel. Yeah, anyway, that's what I have to say about pride. The other thing I think is really, really stupid is people whose pride can be hurt by other people. And this has to do with the same idea of respect that we talked about the other day. Do you remember the other day I was talking about how there was a time when I thought, you know, by the way, I should talk about my divorce video the other day. I told my wife I thought she did not respect me. That was my feelings. And I told another family member, I said, it's obvious that you don't respect me, right? But I didn't do it. Like I told you, I'm pretty resigned to the fact that there's nothing you can do about that. But I wanted those people to know that I'm aware, that's how they feel, or that's how I feel that they, because of the way they treat me, that's how I feel. I feel that they do not respect me. Now with my wife, things changed after that. And our relationship is much better because we communicated, and we had a really actually nice conversation, really nice conversation today about the whole thing, about how, you know, it was tough for a little while, and it's good that we're communicating and everything, and things are good, okay. With another family member, things are not good. They're not good. We just avoid each other. That's all. Just avoid each other, and they don't watch these videos. That person does not watch these videos, so it doesn't matter. But what I wanted to say about that was, one of the important things to take away from that video was, respect yourself, and there's nothing you can do about other people not respecting you. If they don't respect you, there's nothing you can do. You cannot make people respect you at all. All you can do is do your best to live your life correctly, and hopefully, eventually, you know, they might respect you, but that can't be your goal either. Just, if you respect yourself, then fuck everybody else. Live your life correctly, and even if that means that person is someone really important in your life, and that's really sad if that's true. But let's say, for example, that my wife does not respect me, which is not the case I think now, but it was the way I felt months and months ago, because we are under a lot of stress, you know, et cetera, et cetera. If my wife does not respect me, but I think I'm doing a good job, that is a very sad situation, but it's shogunai, meaning it can't be helped and there's nothing you can do about it, so just, you can't change it, right? So just continue to live your life. And bite it, just bite the bullet and go forward and keep trying to do your best regardless of that very, very negative thing. Now here's where it gets really weird. A lot of people can't get past that, I think. Like they say in the movie Pulp Fiction, pride is nothing, it just gets in the way. Like, I can't, if you don't respect me, I can't. You know, you get all angry and shit. Well, you know, if you respect yourself, then fine. You don't respect me, that's fine. I know I'm a good person. I know I'm living my life correctly, and that is enough for me. So I'm going to go forward with that. And one of the things that I see a lot of people doing that I don't get, and it exists in a lot of the world, is the saving face facet of humanity. It's pretty famous in Asia, especially I think with Chinese and Japanese as well, I guess. But people want to save face, right? They want to save face. You can't insult them dishonor them. If you do, then they have to kill you or kill themselves. It's bizarre shit, and it exists in the West as well. I'll show you something. I saw something on Live Leak the other day. It was ridiculous. It was this guy on a motorcycle who chased down this bad driver. He was a Mexican-American or something. Yes, a hyphenated name. He was a Mexican-American. And the guy pulls into a parking lot and finally, the guy on the motorcycle pulls up next to him and says, you know, basically, I don't like the way you're you're driving, I think you're a bad driver. And the Mexican American says, oh yeah, well I fucked your mother. which is just a ridiculous thing to say. And the funny thing about that is that, I mean, he said it over and over. And its intention, of course, is to somehow hurt you, which I thought was ridiculous and hilarious at the same time. Like, you saying you fucked my mother, that's just, I mean, you didn't, obviously you didn't fuck my mother. And how am I supposed to get angry because you said something ridiculous? You know? Okay, I'll one up you. I fucked your father. How about anally? Yes, there you go. While watching cartoons. How about that? Huh? No. In public. I mean, it's just bizarre. It's just ridiculous things to say to people. But the thing is, some people will get angry. Some will say, What did you say about my mother? You know? You don't even know his mother. Why do you care when someone ridiculous says something ridiculous? Some idiot says something really stupid and you're supposed to take affront? You're supposed to be insulted by that? I don't get that at all. But it happens quite a bit. I saw another stupid video where this guy pulls into a Starbucks drive-thru. And some Asian guy, I think it's a Chinese guy, is coming the other way. I think this happened in America. And the Chinese guy, the American guy says to the Chinese guy, he says, you idiot. And the Chinese guy gets mad. He says, what did you say? He says, I called you an idiot. So he punches him. Like, you're really going to be angry because some guy you don't even know called you an idiot when you were being an idiot? I mean, why would you resort to violence? It's just ridiculous to give a shit about what other people think. I mean, you don't even know people. People are crazy. Maybe if someone you knew said something hurtful to you, that could be very disappointing. But really, are you still going to get violent over it? The best thing to do is to acknowledge that in your mind and make decisions about how much emotion you will invest into that relationship in the future. Does that make sense? So if your friend, the person you think is your friend, says something to you very insulting and mean, then you can make a note in the future, okay, well, this person is a mean person. I thought he was my friend, but obviously they're not. So I'm going to invest less time into the future here. Look at this beautiful flower. Look at this beautiful flower. And look at this huge bug. You see that bug there? Look at that bug. Ooh. Well, he's not that huge. People ask me a lot about... Simsen. Kiraisen. Itadakimasu. It's a nice shirt. He had a nice type of Hawaiian Japanese shirt. Okay, so I did a little research about Hawaiians about Japanese, and this is kind of interesting because of this guy's question. It's a little off the subject here. So the top six Japanese communities outside of Japan are, number one, Brazil with 1.4 million people, 1.4, 1.5 million people, 1.2 million people in America. What is it? Let me see. Oh, I forgot now already. There's... I believe, what's the next country over? Is it the Philippines? Let me see. Philippines, England, Peru, and Canada. Yeah, those are the four. The last one, I believe, is Canada. Yeah, I think it's the Philippines. Yeah, Philippines, 120,000, which is quite a bit less. Then 100,000 in England. Then 90,000 in Peru, and like 82,000 in the Philippines. The Philippines apparently was the first country to ever accept immigrants, and they accepted Catholics who were running away because they were being kicked out of Japan. I don't know if you guys know that only 1% of Japan is actually Christian. And back in the day when Catholics, a lot of Portuguese came over and they converted a lot of some Japanese to Catholicism. Those Catholics were later basically chased out of the country, much like the Puritans were chased out of England and had to leave to America. I guess something like that. I don't know. I don't know if that is historically correct, but whatever, you get the idea. Let's see, England, since 1867, they've accepted Japanese immigrants. Peru was the first South American country to accept Japanese immigrants, I think in the late 1800s, maybe 1898 or 89, I forget. Now, this guy who wrote me the annoying letter wants to know why so many Japanese live in America. Well, there's a lot of money to be made in America, and a lot of Japanese have their companies there. So that's one reason. I mean, Toyota, Nissan, Mitsubishi, all these huge Japanese companies, and not just car companies, but other companies. I don't know off the top of my head, but a lot of Japanese companies have businesses and companies and factories in America. So they send their people over there. That's one reason. Another reason is Hawaii. Hawaii is close. So when you see that number, 1.4 million, a lot of that is Hawaiian. And if you go to Hawaii, the Japanese influence is quite apparent there. They even have shrines and temples and such. And a lot of things are in Japanese. A lot of people who work in Hawaii speak Japanese. If you go to Guam, which is not exactly Japanese, but has a lot of Japanese in it, a lot of the staff speak Japanese as well. From what I hear, I've never actually been to Guam, but I've had friends who've worked in Guam, and they told me that their Japanese skills were very, very sought after there. They were able to work in the service industry because there are so many Japanese tourists and people who live there. So anyway, there's that, right? I think the total is like 2.6 million Japanese live in other parts of the world, which is actually, I think, a fairly minor number compared to, I don't know compared to other countries, but I knew compared to New Zealand. Apparently one third of New Zealand lives in other countries or is always traveling and outside of New Zealand. So maybe that's because New Zealand is so small, so maybe it's not fair. But 2.6 million is only, let me see. Japan has 150 million, is it right? No, 125 million people. So 2.6 million is about, I don't know, what is that? 15%? Less than 20%, right? 17% maybe? Whatever, somebody figure it out. That's not really important. But it's not that big a number. But the thing is, percentage-wise and number-wise, it's a different thing, because there are Chinatowns almost everywhere in the world, but there's a billion Chinese people in China alone, so percentage-wise, maybe that's actually pretty low. I don't know how many Chinese live. This is not really about that, but this is not, I don't know how many Chinese live outside of China, but, and a lot of them are probably never coming back, so why would you go back to China, right? Okay, get angry if you want. Anyway, I don't understand pride. I don't understand how you can be insulted by people that you don't know. I don't understand a lot of shit like that. Yeah, so that's basically my little long-assed 4K rant as I walk around the country. And I'm kind of lost. I don't know where I am now. These tambos are full of frogs and sometimes turtles. You see a few turtles in there. I've seen a few turtles today. And in the old days, you'd see a lot of crayfish. But I haven't seen any recently. And of course, we have lots of bees. Oh yeah, I got an email about that. What do you do about the killer hornets that survive, that live here? Well, I've never found a scene. Well, maybe I have. I've seen like one or two killer hornets. Killer hornet, is that what they're called? Those huge, is that what they're called? You know, the things that look like huge bees, but they're this big. Maybe they're not hornets. I forgot the name. But anyway, they're not that many. They're not that many huge bugs. I haven't seen many, but I suppose in other parts of Japan there are. I'm kind of running out of anything else to say. How do I wrap this up? Yeah, I don't understand your pride. housewife just walked out and nodded to me, which is nice to be acknowledged. I must be in a strange sight walking around the countryside talking to my selfie stick like this. Yeah. This is part of Japan. I like this part of Japan. So my wife is off getting her hair done now. And next week we will be in America. So that pretty much wraps it up there. I do have lots of itsy bitsy pieces of video that I've shot that I'd like to share with you guys, but editing right now is taking a lot of time, so I prefer to do this kind of unedited stuff. I hope you guys don't mind this unedited stuff. Oh, and I have started uploading these as audio only podcasts, but they are only available to the Patreon members. So if you're interested, that'll cost you $2 a month, which I think is a very small price to pay to support this, my habit. Okay, that's all for now. Lots more to say, but that's about it for now. Thanks for watching, guys. And I'm going to just walk home now. There's a radio playing over there. You hear that? It's nice out here. You know I'm completely lost. There's some eggplants over there. 35 minutes. Thanks for watching, guys. Please be sure to leave a comment or tell me what you think about your own pride. Distracted video. This is a jumble of thoughts. I hope you got something out of it. Talk to you guys soon.